Hi friends, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. My name is Syed Guri. I'm a history faculty. Today I'm going to discuss the important settlements and headquarters of British in India. The important settlements and the headquarters of British in India. So unlike the other European nations, British came with a different strategy to conquer and to create a sun never setting throughout Indian subcontinent, not only throughout Indian subcontinent, but across the globe. And the better strategy of British to establish few trading stations in the peninsular India. One is at Madras, right, in the southern coastal part of India. Another one is at Calcutta and the eastern coastal part of India, and the western coastal part of India, that was Bombay. These three are the main headquarters of British in India, right? Apart from this, British established, I'm going to discuss this the history of Calcutta and the history of Madras and the history of Bombay in the next episode. I'm going to discuss, so kindly focus on the rest of the settlements of British in India, right? First settlement of British in India from Surat in the year 1608, as we discussed, the British envoy Captain William Hawkins, he secured permission from Jahangir to create a trading station at Surat. That was the first trading station of British in India. And second in the eastern coastal part of India, and that was in the year 1611, Captain Hippen, he arrived at Machilipatnam, where he secured permission from Qutub Shahi ruler in the year 1611 to make a trading station at Machilipatnam. Like the second trading station is Machilipatnam in Andhra Pradesh. And so many trading stations later, like in Bengal, Hooghly, and so many trading stations in Uttar Pradesh, Agra, next in Gujarat, Bhruch, Ahmednagar, right, in Odisha, Balasore was also one of the trading station, which is famous for the missile launching station, Balasore. And next, from Tamil Nadu, Madras was the beautiful trading station of Britishes in India. And from Bengal, Calcutta. And let us discuss the importance of the main headquarters of British in India. Three main headquarters. One is at Madras, another one is at Bombay, and the last one is at Calcutta. At Calcutta, first headquarter of British in India was Madras. Madras. Let us discuss the history of Madras. Madras was created by Francis de in the year 1639. He built Saint George Fort at Madras in the year 1631, and the fortification activities came into force from 1611, but the fort was built in the year 1639. So the credit of making this fort goes to Francis Day, and the credit of making this city goes to Francis Day. He developed this city from the grassroots level, right? So how did he acquire, this is very important thing. So Madras was under the control of Vijayanagara ruler Venkatapati Raya III, and his governor was Damarla Venkatadri Naidu. So the governor of or in charge of this Madras was Damarla Venkatadri Naidu, and Madras was under the control of Vijayanagara ruler Venkatapati Raya III. And here from Damarla Venkatadri Naidu, this man Francis Day received Madras to develop from its grassroots level. But let us discuss, right, and the ancient name, the old name of this Madras was Channapatnam, right? Channapatnam, after the name of the father of Damarla వెంకటాద్రి నాయుడు. దామెర్ల వెంకటాద్రి నాయుడు ఫాదర్ నేమ్ వాస్ చెన్నప్ప, రైట్? ఆఫ్టర్ ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ చెన్నప్ప దిస్ కేమ్ ఇన్ టు నౌన్ యాజ్ చెన్నపట్నం. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ ఈవెంచువల్లీ దిస్ మద్రాస్ చెన్నపట్నం, దెన్ మద్రాస్, నౌ అగైన్ ఈవెంచువల్లీ ద నేమ్ చేంజ్ టు చెన్నై. నౌ దిస్ ఈజ్ కేమ్ టు బి నౌన్ యాజ్ చెన్నై. లైక్ దిస్ ఈజ్ హౌ ద హిస్టరీ ఆఫ్ మద్రాస్ ఈవెంచువల్లీ చేంజ్ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ నేమ్ టు అనదర్. నౌ ద నేమ్ ఈజ్ అగైన్ టర్న్ టు చెన్నై ఫ్రమ్ చెన్నపట్నం. సి దిస్ ద రూట్ of this name is associated, the origin of this name is associated with Damarla Venkatadri Naidu's father Chennappa. So this is very very important thing. However, this Madras received its final shape in the year 1639, but in the year 1684, and this is the first municipality in history, in the history of India, the first municipality. And the characteristic features of a civilized city and the first municipality, that was Madras. The characteristic features of a civilized society and municipality received by Madras, and hence it is recognized as the first municipality and received the status of presidency. What is the first presidency in India? Madras. And next, the history of Bombay. Bombay, as we know that Bombay was received by British from Portuguese. Bombay was under the control of Portuguese before coming to the control of British. As Bombay in the year 1661, there was a marriage ceremony between Portuguese princess and British prince. British prince Charles II and Portuguese princess Catherine Braganza. In the year 1661, as a part of this marriage ceremony or wedding, Portuguese gave this Bombay to British Prince Charles II, right, as a dowry. Thus, this Bombay came under the control of British from Portuguese. But in the year 1668, this Bombay was inherited by John II. Later, this John II, immediately when he inherited this city, and he gave for the further development to Gerald Anjir, he received this Bombay from John II in the year 1668 for the further development, right? Thus, Gerald Anjir took so many actions and for the development of Bombay to its zenith, and immediately Bombay became the great city of India. Though Bombay became the great city of India, it received the presidency status later. It received the presidency status later in the year 1818, during the time of Lord Hastings. Lord Hastings was the Governor General who gave the presidency status to Bombay. That was the history of Bombay. Next, coming to the history of Calcutta, and this is the last headquarter, right? Eastern coastal part of India, Calcutta. In the year 1690, Job Charnock, he was the creator of this Calcutta, and he possessed three villages from the local Mughal governor, and three villages were Kalikata, Govindapur, and one more village, Satanauti, so one more village, right? And these three villages were possessed by Job Charnock to form a great city and metropolitan, and that is Calcutta. But in the year 1690, soon after receiving these three villages, He merged these three and formed a great city, Calcutta, Yamaha Nagar, right? The great city, Calcutta. And soon after receiving this letter, it received the status of presidency in the year 1773. At the time, the Governor General was Warren Hastings. So, friends, today we discuss the three important headquarters of British. Three important headquarters was British. One is at Madras, the second one was at Bombay, and the third one was at Calcutta. So Madras was built by Francis T. Bombay was built by Gerald Angier, and Calcutta was built by Job Charlang. That was the history of these three headquarters of Britishers in India. Thank you, friends. Thank you for your patience. Could you kindly subscribe our channel before watching this video? Do like, share and comment. Thank you.